I wanted to go over the bell work from yesterday, so here we go. You have a benchmark test on Friday. Make sure you know your R2-D2 if you need it. See me. Bell work, 9 pages only, 1 per week. If you have to rewrite it, rewrite it. Makeup testing is this Wednesday. You need corrections and a signature. Only those kids that already signed up from last week. Line symmetry. If you take a rectangle, a long skinny rectangle, you have one line of symmetry here where this side folds onto that side, and you have another line of symmetry here where this side folds onto that one. So I would say 2 lines of symmetry. You cannot fold it on the corners because when you do, this side comes up here and this other side goes down here. And that's not a reflection. Rotational symmetry is anywhere from 0 to 180 degrees. If you turn it anywhere up from 0 to 180, half a circle, and it is the same image, then you would say rotational symmetry. Point symmetry is rotational symmetry, but it's exactly 180 degrees. So if you turn it, let me give you an example of that. If I take this piece of chalk, okay, and you turn it 180 degrees, it still looks the same. So this would be point symmetry, which is also rotational symmetry. It's a special rotational symmetry. Regular. Regular has 2 meanings. All the sides are equal, and all the angles are equal. Angles have the same measure, same degree. 2 things. Isometry, iso means the same. So isometry means congruent figures, the same shape and the same size. All right, here's the bell work. This is a regular pentagon, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sides. Regular because the sides are equal and the angles are equal. Those are equal and these inside ones are equal. Well, you got to figure out the inside one. How much is one of these worth? Well, you take 360 degrees, which is the whole circle, and you divide by 5, and you get 72 degrees. So one of these clicks or chambers is worth 72 degrees. Now, you want to turn D onto B. If you go counterclockwise, there are 2 chambers. So to go counterclockwise, it would be 72 times 2, which is 144 degrees counterclockwise. If you go the other way, clockwise, it would be 1 chamber, 2 chambers, 3 chambers to get to B, so it would be 72 times 3. 216, I think the kid said. All right, that's it. That's called rotational symmetry. You got to figure out how much each one's worth. If it's got 5 chambers, it's 72. If it's got 6, it's 60. A dilation is the new section. A dilation is a transformation, but it can be either an enlargement or a reduction. If someone shines a flashlight in your eye, your pupil reduces to restrict the amount of light coming in. That is a dilation. Scale factor. Take a look here. When I taught at one school, the principal sent the assistant principal, and she said that the principal said I could have anything I wanted. She wanted me to stay because my scores were good. All right, take a look here. You have X, R, T. X and X prime are the same. So this is the point of rotation. I didn't point that out yesterday, but that's what it is. Now, the reason why I tell you the story about that other school is because the kids would always fight right outside my door. And then I'd have to go outside and split them up. And that's what you do on this one. That's the secret, okay? You split the baby triangle from the big triangle. Now, this piece right here is 4. So the little one is 4. This whole piece from here to here is a combination of 4 plus 8. So make sure you add those up and get 12. Some kids only put 8, but it's the whole thing. All right, if you understood that, since the figure is going from small to large, it is a enlargement. So put the larger number on top. So 12 over 4 reduces to 3 over 1. That is your scale factor. It's a 3-to-1 ratio. If it was going from bigger to smaller, then you would go ahead and put the smaller number on top. Now, one thing you keep in mind, the ones with the prime are the second image, really called the image. This is the starting image with no prime, and that's called the pre-image. It's just terminology, but you need to know it. So pre-image. If it's got the tick mark, it's called the image. All right, same thing on this one. This one is a reduction. It's going from bigger to smaller. So put 5 over 10 and reduce it to 1/2. So the scale factor is 1/2. You can pause the video. This one right here, you're going to multiply by a scale factor of 2. But before you do that, you've got to identify where all the points are. Now, if you're still having trouble with points, you need to do better than that. It's always over and up. So here, I go over 3, up 0. Say that to yourself, over and up. Well, this one, you don't go over, you just go up. So it's over 0, up 2. This one is over 0, down 3. This arrow means maps onto. Write that down. Maps onto. And that's a test question. So the image, you're going to multiply the x and the y by 2, all of these. So 2 times 3 is 6, 2 times 0 is 0. 2 times 0 is 0, 2 times 2 is 4, 2 times 0 is 0, 2 times negative 3 is negative 6. This is the image, this is the pre-image, the start one. If you graph this one, you're going to go over 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, up 0, over 0, up 1, 2, 3, 4, and then over 0, down 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What you should have is an image exactly twice as big as the original. And it is. And that's called a scale factor, and that's called an enlargement. Okay? Well, the scale factor, actually, you would have to figure out the distance of the side. So to get the scale factor of this, you want to put the bigger one on top since it's getting bigger. So the original one was 1 block, 2 blocks, 3, 4, 5 blocks for the little one. But the big one is 1 space, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 spaces. So it's a 2-to-1 ratio. That's your scale factor. And that's basically what we did yesterday. There's last night's homework. All right, I hope this helped you. Enjoy. Have a nice day.